I've got this set pretty shallow because it's the first time I've used this machine, and I set my plunge depth really shallow and set it pretty slow. And I'm running a small pattern. But we're gonna see how this works. You just let it run. It plunges when it goes in like this. It doesn't go straight down, it comes in. That way it doesn't overheat the tip and it doesn't break the tip. If this is the first pass, it'll do this 3 more times. That's the reason why it's going slow, and then if you notice it goes off setting, it affects the plunge position of the design effect. Going back and forth just to get it to a chest. The reason why I'm going so small is because, one, I want to see the unit work, and I don't want to cut a big piece of wood to wait a long time, so about as small as you can go with this, but most of my stuff will be anywhere from 2 inches to 10 inches big, so it's good to start with the small stuff just so you can see what's going to do. Second pass. Because he's river, it doesn't go deep, it just comes. It'll go to a certain depth, but this is paintable, and I can have a plunge depth of 1.5 inches with this particular machine. Now, when you start getting into pro stuff, you can go, 4 or 5 inches depending on the machine. But this will go down 1.5 inches, depending on the type of tip I have on there. I've got one tip here, which is what I'm going to be using for the job I'm doing.
That'll plunge down an inch and a quarter. But I'm not going to use that until I get used to the machine. Right now, I'm just getting used to it. So right now, what it's doing is it's trimming up edges. Now it's going to go to its next plunge depth around the B. There it goes. Have it plunging to in a space of a quarter inch so that it doesn't hit the tape, the tip up. Also, if you plunge too deep and move too quick, it chatters the tip. So this is the program, and that's what I told it to do, via the program, and pocket. The pocket is this right here, and then the other one is called profile toolpath, which is this one right here. Typically what you do is, because I didn't want to do it today, because I'm still in the process of learning, is typically if you do this pocket right here, it would have cut this out of the wood, and these spaces right here would have been down the bottom quarter inch of the wood, in other words down here, to hold the centerpiece in place so it doesn't move. And then I would have just taken a little saw or knife and cut this out, and this inner part would come out. But I didn't want to do that with this because I wanted to see how small I can work with it, and I'm really happy that's really small, perfect. So the next one I'm going to do, which is another file, same piece of wood because I've got duplicates of this, and basically I started with this. I put in a rectangle, and you can, the way I do it is, the way I'm preferring to do it is that I'm preferring, instead of drawing it in, I go ahead and enter in the size I want, and then it places it in there, and then I can quickly design something. And once you do that, then you go into the font, like this, and you can select the different fonts, put that in there, and then after that's done, then you go to the tool path and you select this, and right now I've got N mil an eighth, and you select your depths and everything.